Namo Sakyamuni Buddha. Dear Venerable Sangha, Buddhist ladies and gentlemen, you are invited to join us in this weekly Buddhist newsreel on Fuchu Online Channel. Hereafter, 9 major headlines of Buddhist activities of the week. Standing Unit of Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Parochial Council discusses the projected 9th National Buddhist Congress. Government Committee for Religious Affairs organizes seminar Vietnam Buddhist Sangha during 40 years accompanying the nation. Ho Chi Minh City, solemn commemoration of the late most venerable Thich Thien Hao. The 4th Buddhist Congress in Ha Tinh Province, tenure 2022-2027. Vietnam Buddhist University in Hanoi organizes 4th dose vaccination for monastic students. Ho Chi Minh City, Buddhists from Cu Chi District closed 4th summer course The Youth Learn from Buddha in 2022. Bạc Liêu opening the first Buddhist summer camp, Bạc Liêu's Fragrance at Yat Vien Pagoda. Lâm Đồng, Buddhist Charity Section from Đà Lạt City organizes the retreat course and gives gifts to the visual impaired people. Buddhists from District 8, Ho Chi Minh City, Hanover Rural Bridge and houses and give to the disadvantaged in Vĩnh Long and Trà Vinh province. And following are the news and details. Towards the National Buddhist Delegate Congress for the 2022-2027 tenure at Quảng Đức Zen Monastery, Office 2 of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Central Board, a conference of Standing Board Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Parochial Council took place.
Speaking at the opening of the conference, Most Venerable Thich Thiện Nhuân, Chairman of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Administrative Council, revealed the important contents and hoped that the standing dignitaries of the Provincial Buddhist Parochial Boards will contribute ideas to the organizing committee of the 9th National Buddhist Congress for the successful organization. Next, in the scheduled program, Venerable Thich Đức Thiện, Vice Chairman and General Secretary of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Parochial Council, gave a preliminary report on the undertaking during the first 6 months of 2022, and Most Venerable Thich Huệ Thông, Vice Secretary General, Cam Chief of the Central Office 2, approved the program of Buddhist activities in the last 6 months of 2022. It is expected that the 9th National Buddhist Congress with the theme Discipline, Responsibility, Solidarity, and Development be held in 3 days starting on the 27th of November 2022 in Hanoi with over 1,000 official delegates. The conference approved the list of heads of the thematic sections in charge of the National Buddhist Delegate Congress in November 2022. Speaking at the conference, Ms. Trần Thị Minh Nga, Deputy Head of the Government Committee for Religious Affairs, said that the party, state and government highly appreciated the great contributions of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha in the first 6 months of 2022, especially in the social charity activities, which reached over 600 billion Vietnamese dong. She raised the number of points in the law on religion to guide the Sangha in solving problems in organizing Buddhist congresses in provinces and cities, and in managing monks and nuns and monasteries. She also commented on the diplomatic program related to Buddhism in Vietnam and Buddhism in other countries in the region. In the afternoon, the conference continued with the main contents, and the Most Venerable Chairman made a conclusion of the conference.
On the morning of July 11, 2022, the Ministry of Home Affairs, the Government Committee for Religious Affairs, and the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha held a scientific conference with the theme Vietnamese Buddhist Church during 40 years accompanying the nation at Hall T78, Ho Chi Minh City.
The workshop was co-chaired by Mr. Vũ Chiến Thắng, Deputy Minister of Home Affairs, Mr. Vũ Hoài Bắc, Head of the Government Committee for Religious Affairs, and Most Venerable Thich Thiện Nhuân, Chairman of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Parochial Council. In the opening speech, Mr. Vũ Hoài Bắc, head of the Government Committee for Religious Affairs, said that over the past 40 years, the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha has developed strongly in terms of organizational structure, the number of monasteries and Buddhist monks and nuns, religious activities, international exchanges, peace advocacy, morality preservation, and promotion of the nation's cultural traditions in a positive contribution to the country's socio-economic development. At the seminar, the Most Venerable Chairman recalled the historical event of the establishment of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha 40 years ago and affirmed, "The establishment of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha is a rare event in history, a crystallization of wisdom and a sincere desire to unify the thousand-year Buddhism. Over 2,000 years of history, Buddhist monks, nuns, and Buddhists of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha have constantly grown and developed with the country, firmly entering the period of renewal, openness, and international integration, affirming its current role and position. The core is that Sangha members always practice the Buddha's teachings. Serving sentient beings is practically making offerings to the Buddhas. Adorning the world is adorning the pure land of the Buddhas, to contribute to building the pure land of humanity on earth." Most Venerable proposed that the amendment charter of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha needs to be consistent with the Buddhist tradition and current laws. The seminar also received comments from the Venerables and 20 special presentations from the leaders of the Sangha, intellectuals who have accompanied the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha since its establishment until now. At the seminar, Mr. Vu Jintang suggested that the organizing committee continue the meeting and listen to the Venerable monks and nuns, who are historical witnesses in the process of campaigning for the establishment of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha, sharing and collocating the contents in the presentations to submit to the government for issuance of guiding circulars. He affirmed that the party and state would always accompany the Sangha to build and develop a strong Buddhism.
Grateful for the boundless merits of the late Most Venerable Thich Thinh Hao toward the Dharma and the nation, on the morning of July 12, 2022, at the Vietnam National Pagoda in Ho Chi Minh City, the Provincial Buddhist Parochial Board of Ho Chi Minh City solemnly commemorated the 25th year of the Most Venerable's death.
In witness, it was honored to have Patriarchal Most Venerable Thich Chi Quang, Acting Dhamma Master of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha, Most Venerable Thich Thiện Nhơn, Chairman of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Administrative Council, Most Venerable Thich Lệ Trang, Head of Ho Chi Minh City Buddhist Patriarchal Board. In front of the image of the Most Venerable Thich Thiện Hào, the Reverend dignitaries respectfully offer incense to commemorate the merits and pay homage to the late Venerable Master, who devoted his life to the Dhamma and the nation, to revive Buddhism, establish and develop a strong Vietnam Buddhist Sangha. In a dignified and purely serene atmosphere, the aggregation respectfully chanted the Heart of Perfect Wisdom Sutra to make offerings and pray for his spiritual soul to be promoted to the highest rank. Most Venerable Thich Thiện Hào, with his birth name Trương Minh Đạt, was born in 1911 in Ho Chi Minh City, died in 1997 at Xá Lợi Pagoda with 86 years of existence and 66 years of religious service. At the age of 16, he left home with Patriarchal Monk Huệ Đăng, abbot of Thiên Thai Pagoda, Barrier City, in the 42nd generation of the Thiên Thai Zen Congregation. During his religious life, the Most Venerable Thich Thiện Hào fulfilled his responsibility for the nation and the Dhamma. With shining Dhamma merits and human virtues, he was honored to the Sangha to hold many important honorific assignments. The Most Venerable participated in the National Salvation Front, the Southern Liberation Front, and the Patriotic Buddhist Liaison Committee when the country was in danger.
On the morning of July 15, 2022, the Congress of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha in Ha Tinh Province for the tenure 2022-2027 was solemnly held at the Provincial Buddhist Cultural Center.
After the opening speech delivered by Most Venerable Thich Bảo Nghiêm, Venerable Thich Quảng Nguyên reported on Buddhist activities during the 2017-2022 tenure with many important Buddhist achievements, concurrently set out the direction for Buddhist activities for the tenure 2022-2027. Recognizing the great contributions of Buddhism in the province in the past tenure, the central section of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha awarded certificates of accolade to 8 groups and 16 individuals who had many merits in the process of building and developing the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha in Hà Tĩnh Province, tenure 2017-2022. The Provincial Buddhist Parochial Board was also honored to receive a Certificate of Merit from the Prime Minister for making many positive contributions to the great unity of the people in the past tenure. The Central Committee of the Vietnam Fatherland Front and the Provincial Committee of the Vietnam Fatherland Front also awarded Certificates of Merit to groups and individuals who have devoted themselves in Buddhist activities to benefit the cause in life. At the Congress, Most Venerable Thich Bảo Nghiêm was re-elected as head of the Provincial Buddhist Parochial Board in Hà Tĩnh Province for the tenure 2022-2027. Recognizing and appreciating the Buddhist activities of the province's Buddhism, Mr. Lê Ngọc Châu, Vice Chairman of the Provincial People's Committee, hoped that the Provincial Buddhist Parochial Board of Hà Tĩnh Province would continue to enhance its role to build greater national unity, as well implement the policies and laws of the state. In his blessing words at the Congress, the Most Venerable Chairman of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Administrative Council praised the monks, nuns, and Buddhists of Hà Tĩnh Province for the good results of their Buddhist work in the past tenure, and the Most Venerable also hoped that the new Provincial Buddhist Parochial Board would promote the spirit of six harmonies to successfully complete more Buddhist undertakings. These are also the initial achievements presented to welcome the 9th National Buddhist Congress in November in Hanoi. On this occasion, the Buddhist monks of the province held a groundbreaking ceremony under the witness of the honorifics of the Vietnam Buddhist Sangha Parochial Council to build the monks' dormitory block in the Provincial Buddhist Cultural Center.
Under the direction of Most Venerable Rector Thich Thanh Quyết, on the morning of July 12, 2022, the Vietnam Buddhist University in Hanoi organized a COVID-19 vaccination program for all the staff and the monks, nuns, and monastic students.
Venerable Thích Đạo Mẫn, Chief of the Office of the Vietnam Buddhist University, directly monitors the vaccination, ensuring order, seriousness, and safety. This is the first time for the Sapsong Clinic Center to cooperate and accompany the Vietnam Buddhist University in vaccination. The dignitaries of the Operation Council, together with the office teachers and Professor Lương Gia Tĩnh, Vice Rector, were vaccinated with the first dose of Pfizer vaccine. All monks and nuns of the Vietnam Buddhist University were voluntary in getting vaccinated to improve their health and prevent COVID-19. Vaccination is essential and bring peace of mind to the life of monks and nuns studying at the Vietnam Buddhist University, contributing to improving public health and preventing COVID-19. At the end of the injection session, the Venerable Chief of Office on behalf of the Studies Council, monks and nuns sent a souvenir and sincere thanks to the medical staff of the Clinic Center of Sapsong District, Hanoi City.
On the afternoon of July 10, 2022, at Hoàng Linh Pagoda in Củ Chi District, Ho Chi Minh City, the closing ceremony was held for the 4th summer retreat in 2022 with the theme, The Youth Learn from Buddha, participated by 350 students.
After 3 days of practice, the students got used to early waking up at 4:30 a.m. to chant, meditate, walk, fast, recite the Buddha's name, and know how to live independently when away from home. After some time of practice, the ascetic students knew how to love and care for each other, knew how to be polite, respect the senior, and be kind to the junior, promote the virtues of filial piety, see their own faults, know how to help the others, and their souls became more peaceful than before. The monks and nuns expressed love and affection and guided the students to have a useful and joyful retreat and know how to apply what they have learned to live. Venerable Thich Anh Thung, head of the organizing committee of the retreat, reminded the students to regularly visit the pagoda to study Buddhism, listen to the Dharma to know how to apply the Buddha's teachings to life so that they could become good children, good students, and lovely children of Vietnam and Buddhism.
In order to bring a cheerful and useful summer to students, on morning of July 11, 2022, Master Nun Thich Nữ Trúc Như, Abbot of Giác Viên Pagoda, Gia Rai Town, opened the first Buddhist summer camp with the theme Bạc Liêu's Fragrance, with the participation of nearly 500 students.
During a three-day retreat course from July 10 to July 13, 2022, the students together chanted sutra, listened to Dhamma, lit gratitude candles, and performed musical performances, folk games, campfires, and rustic trade fairs. Thereby, they cherished the beauty and cultural identity of Bạc Liêu homeland and nurtured a love for the country so that they would try to learn and become worthwhile citizens. In her opening speech, Master Nun Thich Nữ Trúc Như praised the student's spirit of learning. The abbot wished that the Buddhist summer camp with the theme Bạc Liêu Fragrance would contribute to building a good moral foundation on a compassionate spirit of Buddhism and open a healthy playground for young people. Venerable Thich Phúc Trí praised the merits of the abbot and the venerable monks of the organizing committee of the 2022 Buddhist summer camp at Giác Viên Pagoda. On the site, the children are trained both learning and having fun in a spirit of solidarity, cultivating practical skills that are applied in life. The Venerable Master encouraged the student to actively study and practice, living with a spirit of six harmonies throughout the retreat course. After the opening ceremony, the student listened to the Venerable Thich Quảng Trí, who delivered a lecture on the ritual of lay Buddhism, activities on summer camp rules, and things to keep in mind for the successful participation process.
On July 11, 2022, Dalat City Buddhist Parochial Board held a retreat course, Sharing Love for the Visually Impaired Who Are in Difficulty, at Tâm Ứng Pagoda in Dalat City to sow good fortune to the blind people.
At the retreat, Venerable Thường Tín, Abbot of Sắc Tứ Long Sơn Patriarchal Temple in Khánh Hòa Province, and Venerable Thich Bổn Thắng, Secretary of Trúc Lâm Zen Monastery, Đà Lạt City, shared Dharma talks and ideas, Buddha's teachings to the blind people in Đà Lạt City. The Venerable Thường Tín and the nuns abbots of the pagodas in Gia Yin also organized a cake package and shared it with the blind people. On this occasion, the Buddhist charity section of Đà Lạt City gave 50 portions of gifts, including noodles, cakes, and cash, to support the blind people. Each gift is worth 400,000 Vietnamese dong. This volunteering activity was supported by Pháp Hoa Buddhist Ashram from Ho Chi Minh City and Buddhists at Tâm Ấn Pagoda in Đà Lạt City. The Buddhists made up their mind to support the blind people in Đà Lạt City financially and in kind. This is the first time that the retreat course was held exclusively for the visually impaired in Đà Lạt City. Thereby, the Đà Lạt City Buddhist Charity section has sown good seeds, creating conditions for the Blind Association to access Buddhism and the teachings of the Buddha to transform the sufferings and pains in life, and at the same time give gifts to support the blind people during the retreat course. Monks and nuns from the Đà Lạt City Buddhist Charity section were deeply touched when the blind people in the retreat listened attentively to the Dharma talk with the evidence of joy on their faces and then chanted Namo Amitabha Buddha together. The one-day retreat course with shared gifts is a great encouragement for the visually impaired. Hopefully, the next retreats for the Blind Association in Dalat City would receive a lot of attention and enthusiastic support from Buddhists and sponsors near and far to alleviate the difficulties and hardships for blind people.
On July 10, 2022, the District 8 Buddhist Parochial Board with the Vietnam Fatherland Front Committee of Ho Chi Minh City, the Vietnam Fatherland Front Committee of District 8, the sponsoring board of the Red Cross Society of District 8, in conjunction with the Vietnam Fatherland Front in Vĩnh Long and Trà Vinh provinces, held a ceremony of handing over concrete bridges in the countryside, almshouses, and giving gifts to disadvantaged households in Vĩnh Long and Trà Vinh.
In Vĩnh Long province, a team cut the ribbon to inaugurate and hand over the 28-meter-long bridge worth nearly 200 million Vietnamese dong. The bridge is very meaningful to facilitate a daily commute and for children to go to school with ease and convenience. On this occasion, the team also gave 100 gifts and cash to support local poor people. Each gift is worth 500,000 Vietnamese dong. Then, the team handed over the almshouse of great solidarity to Middle Võ Thanh Tùng's family in Mỹ Thạnh Hamlet, Lục Sĩ Thành Commune, Trà Ôn District. Middle Tùng's family is a very poor household. The Red Cross and the monks also give gifts, necessary household items, and cash to support the family for procurements of more necessities for the new house. At noon on the same day, the team returned to Hội An Pagoda, Vũng Liêm Town, to give scholarships and 50 gifts totaling 60 million Vietnamese dong to the poor, stateless students in the locality. In Trà Vinh province, a team handed over two residential bridges with a total cost of 200 million Vietnamese dong to Đại Phúc and Đà Lộc communes, Châu Thành district. The team also gave 50 gifts to support disadvantaged households. The total amount for this charity donation is 600 million Vietnamese dong, mobilized by Venerable Thích Huệ Công and Most Venerable Thích Thiện Quy, Linh Biểu Pagoda, with support from Buddhists.
Venerable monks and nuns, Buddhist ladies and gentlemen, the last news has signed off this weekly Buddhist Newsreel. Thank you for your attention and following. Goodbye and see you in the next program on Piso TV channel. Namo Sakya Muni Buddha.